Okay, good morning, my moon talk. This morning, I'm gonna do a video on Department of Education, on public education here in the Philippines. The Department of Education, or DepEd as they call it here, provides the nationwide curriculum for schools. And what we're gonna talk about is from kindergarten up to high school. And I'm gonna interview master teacher. My wife is a retired master teacher. And I want to say a couple of background things about my wife, Chon. First of all, she grew up in a very poor environment. She did clothes out in the river. She grew her own food. Any time she had off from school or anything, they gathered wood for the rainy season. And so everything she did, she did on her own. She had a dream and she fulfilled that dream. And she's an inspiration to me and really everybody that knows her. To give you an example, Chon is well in demand as a tutor when she taught in Cotabato City in the southern part of Mindanao. And in Mindanao, the Muslims have an autonomous area, kind of like the Indian reservations. And the head of the particular autonomous area where Chon was is the king. And the king had grandchildren. One in particular was just couldn't read. At a age of a teenager. And so the king brought Chon in as a tutor for his children, and in particular this one child. And in a short work, Chon had brought her through first, second grade level right on up to the high school level. And it was a period, it was a while, but she did it in leaps and bounds. Well, the king was so impressed, and the queen, that they made her the royal tutor. I mean, she was part of the crown. And so you can see in pictures of the royal family, there's Chon right there, the royal tutor. So with that, I'm gonna now go over and then introduce, let Chon talk, and then we're gonna go. I'm not like Bud, I have to have notes. So I'm gonna ask questions, and I'll be off camera and we'll let my darling answer them. Okay. Good morning, darling.
Good morning to all. Good morning, my mahalo.
Okay, let me start with some questions. I know you were a master teacher for how many years?
So I've been teaching for 25 years.
Mm-hmm. And what grades did you teach?
I taught grade 2, grade 3, grade 5, and third year high school.
Okay. And what are your qualifications?
I am a graduate in Bachelor of Science in Fishery Education. I am a Masteral Graduate, Master of Professional and Development Education, major in Educational Management, minor in Public Affairs Management.
Okay. I'm impressed. Okay, here's one I think people are interested, certainly I was. What does it cost to send a child to public school?
The public, if you have to send your children in private school, that's very expensive. And the government or public schools, that is all free.
I see, okay. Because you hear a lot of things, people say, oh, I have to have money to send my child to school, but really it's free, right?
Yes, public school is really free.
Okay, and what is the teacher's responsibility towards the children?
The teacher's responsibility towards her children is to mold them spiritually, to develop their spiritual, physical, in the physical aspect, the mental ability of the children, to prepare them to be a good citizen in the country and the whole world.
Okay. And what language did you use to teach the children and maybe speak to the children who weren't familiar with Visayan or Tagalog?
So we use the international English, and we use our national language, which is the Filipino.
And what about, I'm sure there were some of the children in the Muslim, from the Muslim areas, who spoke various Muslim languages, is that right?
Yes. And Muslims, there are different dialects, the Maranao, the Maguindanao, the Taosug, and the Huluano, but they are very fluent in speaking English and also in Filipino, so it's not hard for them to teach.
Okay. And how many children were in your class?
So in the classroom, as what I have experienced, 40 to 50 school children inside the classroom.
Wow!
Yes.
And what's the most you had in your classroom?
Some Muslims, but majority is a Christian.
But how many numbers? What's the maximum
50.
Number?
I experienced 50. And in the high school, I experienced having more than 70 students.
Wow. Okay. And who cleaned up your classroom? Do you have the janitor or no?
In the public schools, the school children, they are responsible in cleaning the classroom inside and outside the classroom, and also the teachers. So there is a grouping. We group the school children from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. So they are already grouped to be assigned in a particular school days.
So did they work outside as well?
They also clean outside the school.
And what about teaching them to take care of outside, like gardens and stuff? Did they
yes.
teach that part of the curriculum?
Yes, that is a part of the curriculum. Even in grades 1, they already taught how to grow their own food, like planting vegetable. Like having vegetable garden inside the school campus, so they have fun and they really like and they really enjoy, and there is knowledge for that.
Wow, sounds great. I've seen some children that bring their younger brothers or sister to school because there was no one to mind them at home. Is that okay? Is that acceptable?
Actually, it's not acceptable in the school, but in that is only case to case basis. As far as I know, it's really not allowed, because it is still the responsible of the parents to take care of their children.
Okay. And how much does a teacher starting out, a new teacher, about how much money do they make?
So the newly hired teacher, they receive 20,000 or 20,000, 21 as of now.
Okay.
It's monthly.
Mm. Okay, so 50 pesos to a dollar, 20,000.
Yes.
Okay. I understand teachers are required to go to each child's home and see what kind of environment they have for a home life. Is that true?
Yes, that is very true. Teachers, the public school teachers, particularly the public school teachers, we must be involved. Community, we must be get in touch with the community, and one of that is the home visitation. You have to be keep in touch also to the parents.
And can the parents come in and talk to you almost any time during the day?
Yes, they are free to come to our school, to the advisor. So I already gave them the time where I am available in the school. Like for example, I told them I am free to entertain you whatever questions. So that is 12 to 1 o'clock, and in the afternoon 4:30 to 5 o'clock. Or I also told them that I am available at home during Saturday afternoon. So we have a good bonding between the parents as well as the community.
That's great. Come home, can go. Okay, are Filipino children pretty well behaved in the class?
Yes, the Filipino school children, they really behave inside the classroom.
Mm. And what was the hardest thing about being a teacher? Lesson plans, maybe?
As I experienced before, the hardest thing as a teacher is the paperwork, because we have to prepare a detailed lesson plan, which is an addition to our paperwork. And secondly, it's really hard to discipline the school children. It's very hard to discipline inside the classroom, but it's the a good management of the teacher.
Okay, so I have one last question. Is your husband a fine figure of a man?
Yes, it's a big, big yes. My husband is a superhero, super guapo, the best of all.
Well, thank you, my darling. Thank you for being this interview with me.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you very much, my husband, my guapo, my darling. So, thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you for watching.